And for the second fight of the night, we got my boy Yancy Medeiros, 15-7, taking on Demir Hazlevich, the Bosnian bomber. This fight here is set up to be a war. For Yancy, he's the Hawaiian Diaz brother. Everybody knows that. He comes in with that heavy boxing style, mixes it up well. We know about his jiu-jitsu. The problem I have with Yancy is he does get hit a little too much for my liking. He always is relying on his toughness. He's dropped 3 in a row. Now, the last 3 that he's dropped is 2 big names in the division. And he is in for a tough one here in this fight against the Bosnian bomber. For Yancy, his last fights, I believe that was against Lando, Gregor Gillespie, and then Cerrone. All losses. And then he's been... It's only been fighting, I think, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think it's like once a year.
Yeah, pretty much.
As of recently, you know. And so I would like to see some more consistency from him, see him in there a little more often. But it is Yancy, and you can't count him out. He's a tough dude. On the other end with Demir, 13-6. Demir also has good striking, loves to stand and box it out. Not a very good grappler by any means, but I also think that his gas tank might come into question. We know Yancy can go all day. If this fight does go into the later rounds, the more I see the fight favoring Yancy. Demir loves the counter striking, and if he does plan on waiting on Yancy, he may take some damage straight to the face and get scored on before he's able to get something off and able to get the victory. So. This is a tough fight, and I think this one could go, you know, either way. What do you got?
Yeah, the more I think about it, man, I'm just gonna have to go another Demir on this one again. I love Yancy, man. He's a, you know, fan favorite. He's been in there with the best of them, had the brawls, you know. He's took a lot of L's, man, and his chin hasn't been holding up too much. Not saying that Demir is a, you know, power puncher and whatnot, but he can get the job done when he needs to. He definitely moves forward and pressures, which is a good trait against Yancy, because Yancy doesn't do too good on his back foot. But as far as the record goes, Demir's coming here with a 13-6 record, and he's coming off of a two fight losing skid. So Yancy's off of 3, this man's off of 2. Both of them know their backs are against the wall, so I imagine this is going to be a really fun fight. I just have to side with Demir, man. I believe his In his recent string of fights, he's looked more impressive than Yancy has. Just going back a few fights, you know, back in 2017, he had that great win over Marcin Hill where he kneed him, caught him coming in with a knee while he was shooting. It was beautifully timed. Got a knockout there. Had a split decision win over Nick Hine, which in hindsight, Nick Hine's, you know, doing good. So
I like how you did that.
And, he had a knockout win over Polo Reyes. I don't even believe Polo Reyes is in the UFC no more. So good to see that he can get him out of there when he needed to. And then the 2 losses that he is coming off of is against Christos Giagos, who we just saw last week do work, and Renato Moicano. And that one was a weird one, man. It was hella funny. He just got choked out within a minute, and he was saying, "Why don't you want to fight? Let's fight. You just choked me." It was comical. So that last one, I don't really know what to take away from it. It was just he was out positioned really quick and just got choked out, and Moicano can do that to people. So I don't really take too much stock in that. But yeah, as far as him coming forward, he is the aggressor. I don't believe he's going to be the faster striker here, but I believe he's going to be the more durable. So being more durable against Yancy is a good trait, because Yancy does, man, he, you know,
he gets hit.
I don't like to hate on my boy.
He does get hit. I do like the length that he's got as well. I mean, the reach on Yancy is 75.5 to Demir is 70, and that may pay dividend as well as in the boxing range. Also, they have the line, which is pretty damn close. So for Yancy, he's -105, and the Bosnian bomber at -125. So I mean, it looks like the oddsmakers got him close as well. Who you taking for the pick?
I'm taking Demir.
Demir. I'm gonna go Yancy, but this is a tough fight. And
yeah. Well, listening to one of the interviews, which was pretty telling for me, Yancy was saying that he pretty much just waits too much, man. He knows that. So in turn, what is he gonna do? Come out firing aggressive? And if that does happen, I just feel on the flip side, Demir's interview that he had, he said that he just knows he needs to be calculated. He has a one-track mind, and he just wants to be in the UFC, and Yancey was already talking about moving on, and I think the writing's on the wall, even though I hate to say it. I love Yancey. He's a fan favorite. Hopefully, it's just a fun fight, and they both get invited back to, you know, fight again, but the pick for me is going to have to be Demir.
All right, so Rock's going the Bosnian Bomber. I'm going to take the Hawaiian Yancey Medeiros. This is going to be a tough one. I think both guys is back against the wall and a must win for both fellas here.